Hey, it's Ray Steele. Hope you like this, and please hit the subscribe button. Appreciate it.
I have learned much from this gentleman over the years. Most recently, if I ever go to Sri Lanka and I order chicken at a restaurant, make sure it's chicken that they actually bring to you. You can read about that in his most recent book. It's a memoir called Riding the Elephant. He's done so much. Of course, we remember him as the host of the Late Late Show on another network, which that seems like forever ago now because I haven't watched the Late Late Show since then. Can't wait to see Craig Ferguson back at the Egyptian Room in Indianapolis on September 17th. Mr. Ferguson, welcome. How are you doing today?
I'm good, Raymond. How are you? You don't mind if I call you Raymond. I could shorten it to Ray, but I feel until we know each other better, I think Raymond or even Raimondo might be the way to go. Is that okay?
I would be honored to call me anything if you want to call me Raymond. Usually the only one, it pops up as Raymond on the Zoom because that's the way the company has it. Two, the right. Only other person who calls me Raymond is my wife when she's pissed off at me. So.
Yeah, but you know what's weird? When my wife's pissed off at me, she also calls me Raymond, which I don't understand. I don't understand.
I've not been to Scotland, so I would not be the reason for that. It's funny. The last time we spoke, I was at radio here in Indianapolis. The SoundCloud file that I listened to today before this interview said it was 7 years ago, just before another show at the Egyptian Room in Indianapolis. Yeah. So a fair bit has happened since 2015 for yourself.
Do I have to cover all of that? Do I have to talk about whatever happened in the world between 2015 and now?
No, we're not going to talk about that. I do want to touch on one thing, though. And if, by the way, if you have not seen Craig's series, Hobo Fabulous, about, I believe, your most recent tour in the United States for this one, it's on Amazon Prime. It's well worth your time. But in that last episode, you said that you never say never, but you thought that was going to be it as far as touring. And yet, here you are.
Yeah, you know what happened? I don't know if you noticed, but in 2019, actually just the beginning of 2020, the world went into some weird, I don't want to get into all that, but I was at home for a long time and I thought, you know, I really feel like I should go on tour. And then my wife started calling me Raymond all the time and I think it's time to get out.
The joke itself does not exist, but the punchline exists, but it's good. It's such a good punchline. I think I should tell it to you so you know. The punchline of the joke is, what are you talking about? The first time he tried it, he was sick. The second time, his hat blew off. See? You didn't even hear the joke, and you're like, not bad, not bad.
I missed it. I'll be honest with you. I missed doing the live shows, and I missed the travel, and I missed the vibe of it, and I'm very glad to be back doing it again. I just missed it.
And something else about the end of that show, or something that we learned from Hobo Fabulous, is the last time we spoke, we talked about you being a U.S. citizen. You had written the book about becoming an American and all that went into that process. And now you've moved back to Scotland. If you don't mind me asking, why the move back home for you, if you will?
Well, it is, and I didn't. I mean, I'm there a lot of the time, and I have a house there. But, I mean, look, it depends on who you talk to. If you talk to the IRS, I haven't gone anywhere. I didn't even go to the end of the block. So, I'm still an American, and I still spend a lot of time in America. In fact, we're just talking about maybe it's time to think about coming back again. We're not really sure. So, I don't have a hard and fast rule about it. I went there. We went there because really we had been going there a lot for downtime and we wanted to spend more time there. And I like it there. I don't know if you know Scotland. It's a fantastic place. I love it. So I like going there.
I'd love to go someday. Now and my wife would too. Yeah.
It's great. It's lovely. Well, you know what? Maybe if you would surprise her with a trip there, you wouldn't hear Raymond quite so much. You might just hear Ray. That is the loveliest thing. You surprised us with a trip to Scotland. Yeah. You'd be getting called Ray for a while, I think.
I would hope so. Yeah. September 17th is when Craig is at the Egyptian Room here in Indianapolis. Yeah. It is a place that it was funny. I remember when we saw that show the first time and you came on stage, had a little bit of fun with the name, the Egyptian Room. I kind of find it funny, too. But I know it's because that was once the Murat Shriners Temple. in Indianapolis is what that auditorium is, or the entire building. So that's why it's called the Egyptian Room, just so we know.
Yeah, I now have an Egyptian room in my house where I, well, yeah, but no contemporary Egyptian, ancient Egyptian. I go in there and I wear eye makeup and I walk in a certain fashion. Not in any way. Well, I'm a little hieroglyphic-y in my setup. I'm fascinated by ancient Egypt, and I always have been. So playing the Egyptian room is something that I remember very fondly. And I like it very much. I love the decor. I'm not in any way being dismissive of it. I think it's really cool. And I think more places should have Egyptian rooms.
My friend Karis, who is an Egyptologist, she calls me up from Egypt and she says, we found this joke. And I was like, oh, well, that's great. Tell me the joke. So she, you know, she tells me the joke. But I don't speak ancient Egyptian. It was like, I will guys with a dog's head. I'm like, it's not that funny. Wow, I had no idea so many ancient Egyptians were here this evening.
You mentioned something in the last show. I want to bring this up, too, about people who think they are comedians, but they don't really do stand-up the way you always did stand-up, the way a lot of comedians were brought up doing stand-up. As you put it, they do 5 minutes on YouTube, and they think they're a comedian, and they really haven't put in the work. And some other comic friends of mine, there's one who lives here in central Indiana, Scott Long, and he's pretty much quit doing comedy clubs now because, one, he makes more money doing corporate shows, but two, it's the comedy clubs here increasingly don't want your traditional stand-up comedians. They're looking for celebrities. They're looking for YouTubers. They're looking for TikTok celebrities. It's changed a lot over the years.
I think it's okay. Things change. You know, I mean, I think, you know, I hate being held accountable for things I said and I don't remember saying. But I think that it's okay. The things do change, and I don't want to be saying, oh, it was better in the old days. It's a different way of doing things. If I was starting out today, I would totally be doing TikTok and YouTube. Of course I would. I mean, it's what young comedians are doing, and they should. And things are changing because they should change. And young people are making it different because that's what young people are meant to do. And I'm frightened of it because I'm old, and young people should frighten me. And that's good. It's healthy. So I don't have a huge problem with it, to be honest. I kind of feel at this point, if you're coming to see me, it's because you know who I am. It's not the label of whether I'm a comedian or not a comedian, or whether I do TikTok or not TikTok. I don't think anybody really cares at this point. Well, certainly I don't. So, like, if you want to come see me, I'll be doing me. And I think what's sad is when you see older comedians like me trying to not be old. I think that's sad. But I will not be trying not to be old. I'll just be being whatever age I am, which is 60 years old, which sounds enormously old to me, but I suppose isn't really that much. Or maybe it is. I don't know. It is what it is. It's just a number.
It is just a number. But I mean, are you happy to have made it to 60? You've written a lot about your vices in the past that you don't do anymore.
I'm surprised to have made it to 60. Happy? Yes, of course. I mean, I'd rather be here than not here, I think. I don't know. I've never been anywhere else. Well, for a while. It's funny. Turning 50 messed with me a lot more than turning 60. Turning 50 was horrendous. I was like, oh my God, what am I going to do? But 60, I'm like, it's okay. You know, I'm still here. Still, I can, for the most part, still move around. And, you know, I just lucky. I think what a lot of us, certainly I took for the last couple of years of, you know, this dreadful COVID thing was being grateful for being able to, you know, suck air in and out and walk around and just like basic things of life. I'm just, it's helped me with gratitude.
Now, let's see, September 17th is the show. I'm kind of surprised. Again, I keep going back to Hobo Fabulous because it was just such a great, fun series to watch.
Thanks.
Kind of surprised that your youngest son, Liam, is not your opening act. Little man was fun. He was hilarious.
Well, you know, I have been very strict with Liam. He has to go to school, and so he'll be at school. He's in school right now. And also, I don't have an opening act. You know, people do say to me, why don't you have an opening act? And I say, well, I kind of think the thing to do, rather than have an opening act, what I'll do is I'll suck for the first 20 minutes and charge myself a grand. That way everybody gets the same effect without, you know, doing everything else. No disrespect to anyone who's opened for me in the past.
none taken, I'm sure, by anybody. And I hope Liam has taken the sunglasses off. I don't think he took the sunglasses off the whole series, or at least for the end.
I wouldn't let him. That's the reason. He's not like sunglasses crazy. I wouldn't let him not wear sunglasses if he was going to be on camera, because I said, no, you can't. You're too little to have people come over and say, I know you, because he wouldn't understand it. And he doesn't like it when people do it to me. It was for his protection. I made him wear sunglasses and a mustache.
Craig Ferguson at the Egyptian Room, September 17th. We'll have the info, ticket info at WRTV.com. Please go check him out. If you have not seen him, or even if you have seen him before, go see Craig and the Ramon shirt there. Well, probably not the Ramon shirt, I'm guessing, on stage.
I doubt I'll wear it, on stage, but you know, you never know. You never know until the night.
Never can tell. Craig, it's been so fun watching you and enjoying your stuff over the years, and can't wait to see you when you get to town. Thank you.
Thanks, Ray. Come and say hi at the show, will you?